Welcome to another fantastic edition of Expert Talks here on Kalkine TV. I'm your host, Sage. Today we have Vish Ramakrishnan, the founder and CEO of CogniFrame, with us. And for some background, CogniFrame operate in the financial services and healthcare sectors. They help institutions improve outcomes using hybrid quantum and near quantum. Their solutions are based on machine learning, quantum optimization and simulations. Very exciting stuff. Well, here to tell us more is Vish Ramakrishnan, founder and CEO of CogniFrame. Welcome to the show, Vish.
Thank you.
To start with, it's quite complex what you do, to be honest. So how do you think quantum computing could change the financial services and healthcare industry?
Well, quantum is a huge disruption waiting to happen. When you think about it, everything that you do classically, for example, encryption, will be broken with quantum. Quantum will speed up computations. It'll help solve intractable problems, things that you can't do today. It'll have huge impacts in machine learning. It'll have impacts in all kinds of simulations. Combinatorial type of optimization problems where, you know, you have a lot of variables and you need to crunch through a lot of stuff to find the most optimal solution. And in healthcare, where, you know, whether it's in terms of discovering new drugs or in terms of being able to properly assemble the genome or even analyzing images to be able to figure out if those are cancerous or not. So it's got a lot of applications across a variety of industries. And in these two sectors, definitely it has huge implications.
Thanks, Vish. So it sounds like quantum computers are a little bit closer than we think they are. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, there are things you can do today, Sage, and there are things you can't do today. I mean, it's sort of at a point where there are serious advances in areas that require things like graph, graph kind of problems or combinatorial optimization problems. And then there are problems that can be solved by using a mix of classical and quantum today. There are still challenges in terms of quality, scalability, et cetera, but these are being addressed. And there are solutions currently available today that are commercial grade and are producing results. So it's very exciting, really.
Absolutely. It just sounds amazing that this technology might be available to the layperson in the near future and might be even affordable. So Vish, moving on with the discussion, would you please tell us a little bit more about solutions that CogniFrame actually provides to clients?
Right. So we launched what's called the world's first quantum app store in earlier this year. And essentially it's a plug and play aggregator app store so that people who do not understand quantum or do not have quantum resources can essentially just upload data and get results without having to go through that entire process of trying to figure out what technology is going to work or have the resources on hand. So that's one of the things we do, where we have a bunch of curated use cases on the platform. And these are essentially use cases that are pretty common. Things like creating a random number or creating a crypto key or being able to solve certain problems with machine learning. In addition to this, we have worked on a number of other solutions that are not necessarily on this platform just as yet, but were still being used by customers using the infrastructure behind the platform, which is really supported by the stuff we have from, we have two kinds of hardware behind this platform, one of which is a simulated bifurcation machine from Toshiba. We have a partnership with them, which allows us to utilize that on the back end. And then we have a gate simulator that simulates what would happen with a sort of a circuit-based machine as well. So we have two kinds of technologies running in the background, and we're able to solve these kind of problems. We've also done a lot of work in the area of healthcare, where we have actually been able to show that we can speed up drug discovery significantly, and we're about to commercialize that over the next few months. So that's pretty exciting for us. So that's what we've been doing at CogniFrame. We're very excited.
That sounds amazing, Vish. I mean, with some of the budgets on projects that your clients are probably working on, any insight that your technology can offer them must be such a great help. So can we move on to the construction industry now? In your opinion, okay, how is it becoming more autonomous versus automotive?
Sorry, are you saying how's construction industry becoming more autonomous?
Yes.
Right. So in the automotive industry, for example, and in the construction industry, there are new materials being discovered that can be used. And so new chemical compositions can be designed using quantum. So whether it's in terms of new building materials or more durable materials, stronger materials, etc., can be designed, because you can actually play around with items in the chemical space and actually design them. And that's true of the automotive industry as well, because you can actually work around in terms of new material to construct cars, etc. So these are pretty huge changes that are coming down the tube. Large automakers, large construction companies are all working on new kinds of materials.
Thank you so much. So in your opinion, how are CogniFrame's hybrid solutions unique than others available in the market? What sets you aside from your competitors?
Right. So if you look at the market itself, you have hardware players. They essentially make different kinds of hardware that's available in the market. And then you have people who make the tools that are useful to program and utilize this hardware. And then you have companies that are consulting companies, large consulting companies, that essentially will go to an enterprise and help them figure out their problems and figure out what kind of quantum solutions would help solve those problems. There's a fourth category, which is really companies that have designed one or two solutions specific to a industry or vertical. And we fall in that category. So number one, that is an important differentiator. We're not in the first three categories. The second part of it is we have this plug and play application store. So what we're doing is we're obviating the need to learn quantum. We are making quantum available to all enterprises without actually making a huge investment in technology that's still relatively new, and where you do not know who the winner is going to be 5 years down the road. So in many ways, by using our plug and play technology, all they need to do, all customers need to do, is essentially download an app, upload data related to a use case, and receive results. So there is no learning of the technology, there is no programming, there's no algorithms to be written. So it sort of simplifies the whole process and adoption of quantum.
That's very interesting to note, because I think the AI sector and much of this deep tech goes through a process of a process of chain links that have to be done before progress can be made step by step. And if any part of that process is missing, then you don't find the results that you needed. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, so with quantum, I mean, you have to remember one thing. With traditional classical computing, you have something called memory, so you can store data. With quantum, there is no such thing as quantum memory, just as yet. So you can't actually store a quantum state. So in many ways, quantum will continue to remain hybrid. So you need classical to run quantum. You can't run quantum independently. So in that sense, there is a dependency. There's also the other factor that you need to be able to scale. And to scale, because there are limitations to what you can do with quantum today, a lot of processes still use classical. And so like AI, you still need to use a lot of classical to be able to use quantum.
Okay, thank you so much for elaborating on that. Could you also talk about the significant milestones your own company, CogniFrame, has achieved in the past few months?
Well, we launched our first Q store, which is the first quantum app store, which is the only one of its kind anywhere. And we've got a lot of people trying the platform, utilizing some of the use cases on it. And then we've also done a lot of work in the area of drug discovery, and we're about to commercially launch that, which means there will be commercial revenues from the launch of that solution, which is a huge, huge milestone for us. We're also working on a number of other projects, as I said, in genomics, where we're looking at how do you sequence and how do you assemble the entire genome, because right now you can't actually assemble the entire genome. You can only do about 92%, so there's still a portion that's not assembled yet. And so there are ways you can do that using a near quantum or a hybrid quantum approach. And then we're also working on the imaging side, medical imaging side. So there are a number of projects ongoing, plus we're working in the area of finance. We're working on areas related to forecasting, economic modeling and forecasting using dynamic programming. So there are exciting stuff happening within CogniFrame.
That is so amazing to hear. I mean, biotechnology is just expanding leaps and bounds, and we're so excited to hear that you are playing a part in sequencing the entire genome. Wow, that is mind-blowing. Vish, are there any risks involved with the adoption of quantum, in your opinion? And if yes, can you please suggest ways of de-risking the space?
Right, there are risks. I mean, the risks are because there are so many different kinds of technologies. You have, you have semiconductors, you have silicon, you have photonics, you have ion traps, and you have annealers. So you have so many different types of technologies available there. As an enterprise, when you want to look at quantum, you do not know what to touch or not to touch. And so that's a challenge and that's a risk. And that's part of the reason why we went in with this first queue approach, where customers don't really need to bet on any particular technology. They can just utilize the use case, pay for the use of that use case, and be done with it for now until the technology really matures. But having said that, there's a lot of money going into this, and there is a lot of changes that are happening in this area, a lot of new things coming through every day. And it's only a matter of time, maybe 2-3 years from now, when the technology really gets to a point where some serious stuff gets done with it.
Thanks, Vish, for sharing your musings. It is such an exciting space to be watching. So what are your objectives at CogniFrame for the rest of this year, 2022, please?
Well, we obviously want to further strengthen the store, which is what we've been working on for a while. And then we want to launch the drug discovery product, because we've done a lot of testing over the last year. And we're right about ready to go live as a bunch of pharmaceutical companies, and the largest research institution in North America is working with us. And we're about to take that to market over the next month or two. So that's exciting for us. That's going to keep us busy for the rest of the year.
Yes, definitely an exciting space to watch. And it seems that ethics must come into play in a big way in your sector when you're still ideating with this new technology and how far to go with it, as you said before. Were there any closing thoughts you'd like to add on that before we finish the discussion?
Yeah, well, quantum is about computation. So ethics is less, unlike AI, there's less of an ethics angle to this. Although when you do start using quantum machine learning, you will run up against those same issues. But really, for the rest of it, you're solving problems either faster or you're solving intractable problems. So in that sense, you have less to do with ethics, more to do with computational power and being able to solve problems.
Fantastic. Well, thank you again for joining us. We really do appreciate your time and insights you shared today.
Thank you so much.
Thanks so much for joining us today, Vish. We really do appreciate your time and your insights. And for those of you who've just joined us, we had a very informative discussion with Vish Ramakrishnan. He's the CEO, founder of CogniFrame. And you can watch the full interview on Kalkine Media's YouTube channel and keep watching for more of these live expert talks and market insights. Till the next episode, stay apprised and invest wise with Kalkine Media.